And it's not even a tax on you. It's a tax on me.
Raj, next man's over there. Raj, what I'm trying to say.
Your issue with the concept of jizya is the fact that it's an oppressive taxation system of the non-Muslim.
Yeah.
Where in reality, a Muslim has the harder end. And I'll explain why we have the harder end of the deal, right? In terms of warfare, in terms of war, we have no choice but to fight. Whereas the non-Muslim Raj has the option of either paying jizya or even going to fight. Now you yourself, my brother, no offense, look like someone that's not a soldier, you're not willing to fight. So why not just pay the jizya?
Trust me, I'll fight if I
would have you to. Fight, Raj?
You know I'm 43 now, 44, so when I was younger, I didn't always be like this.
Okay, but Raj.
So obviously,
Raj,
I'm older now.
So you would be right.
Alright, let me explain why I have a problem with jizya in the tax. In India, we have had a history of the jizya tax. It's not like some tax that we've never experienced.
Was it jizya that you
said? It's a jizya tax by the Islamic conquest and the rulers. They enforced it, the Mughal empires, they enforced the jizya tax, and I'm not going to pay that bullshit tax anymore. So, and the other thing is, the tax system, the whole point about the tax system, is that everyone should have equal rights. In the UK, if I pay a certain amount of tax and another man pays a certain amount of tax, legally we still have the same rights. If I wanted to build something down the road, I could build it. You want to build it, you could build it. If I commit a crime, same punishment, The problem with the jizya tax is that the person who's paying the jizya is a dhimmi, a second class citizen, and cannot propagate or do things that you would be able to do. So for an example, you would be able to go over and try and convert my people. If you want, you could do dawah in our areas, But what we couldn't do is to go to your areas and try and convert you.
If you're talking from an equality standpoint, The non-Muslim has two choices, pay jizya or go to war. The Muslim has only had one option. So who has the harder end of the bargain?
Hold on.
Ask my question. How many times
do people go to war?
It's a very straightforward question.
When you're talking about wars, you're making
one option.
How many times would someone go to a war within their own lifetime?
Listen, Raj.
I'm asking you a question.
No, you can't ask my question.
Because you're making it as if going to war is something that's normal, that happens every year.
If you don't want to pay the jizya, you just sign up to the army. That's fine.
What I'm saying to you is that.
Exactly. So then
when I say, what I don't understand about you guys, you get so upset when I say, I ain't paying that bullshit.
If I come in week in, week out, I say to you, F the turban. I'm attacking your religious identity. Let me explain something. I need to answer it.
It's not a simple yes or no. When you're attacking the turban, that is something that I'm wearing. Something that is part of my religion.
An identity.
The tax system that you expect me to pay,
which is me, part of my religious identity.
You're enforcing onto me. I have a right to call it a bullshit tax system?
No, because shall I tell you why? If I say bullshit term and bullshit term,
you can't equate the two. Even if you did, it would have bothered my religious identity.
So how can I not equate the two?
But even if you did, it would have bothered me.
Because it doesn't bother you. Wait, so it's part of my religious identity.
But the thing is, if you are bothered by me saying bullshit jizya, you have got a very soft skin.
Let me just clarify something. Is it a tax system? No, you're posing questions. So I'll ask you two questions. The Muslim has one option. Option A is to go to war, right? Where the non-Muslim has two options, where you pay the jizya or you go to war. So who has the harder end of the bargain? Answer that question.
Alright, if you had to go to war all the time,
answer the question,
then
Raj.
You would have the harder end of the bargain.
Answer the question.
But going to war is not something that happens in some people's a whole of their lifetime. You could go for the whole of your lifetime not going to a single war or a battle. Yeah, this is not a time here where people are battling 24/7. Yeah.
He's trying to.
Well, that's when you sign up to the army, like people in Israel, they're signing up to the army.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, there might be no wars going on.
Yeah. Alright. So I want people to understand. I will keep on saying I ain't paying that bullshit, Jizya, because it's a tax. A tax like the poll tax. A tax like the income tax, yeah? A tax like any tax. And I am not going to revere this tax like you see it as some kind of amazing thing that I cannot critique. When I say it's a bullshit tax, I mean it. It's shit to me.
Why are you referring? Listen, what I'm saying is, it's part of my religious identity.
I believe in La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. I believe in all the things that are said in the Quran and the ways of the Prophet in the Sunnah. Right? The jizya is part of the Sunnah. It's part of my religious identity. By you saying bullshit jizya, it's an attack on my religion.
What is an attack then?
It's an attack on my religion. And that therefore, I would ask you politely, because now I've seen people online, right? Yeah. A guy that's wearing a quote that you started saying, I'm not paying that bullshit jizya. Yeah. And when your followers.
Big him up.
Your followers. That's inciting violence. So I'll tell you why, right? Let me just finish my point. You have certain people that have an agenda against Islam. They have agendas against Islam that are not educated on Islam by wearing t-shirts, I'm not paying that bullshit jizya.
It incites violence, to me it doesn't.
It's a form of hate.
Well, you need to prove it. I did prove it. Show me something from that particular t-shirt that has caused violence.
Bullshit jizya.
Show me a causation that has caused violence.
There's no causation. Your platform, yeah, most of your followers, yeah,
Racist, like Saeed.
Like Saeed.
So do you condemn Saeed? So my followers are racist. What's your crime to be a racist? Yeah, so what are you going to say about people that support me? So let me ask you a question. Have you ever heard me say something against your prophet? Hold on.
It's not critique.
Have you ever said anything against your prophet? Against Allah? Against the Quran? Against anything? So the only thing I've said is, I ain't paying that bullshit jizya, which is a tax you expect non-Muslims to
win. It is a slogan. It's your ad-lib now. People started to wear t-shirts and inciting violence.
And Muslims.
You made a very bold claim. Yes, I've made that.
You've gone from the lead for me having someone wearing a t-shirt going over to Charlie Hebdo.
I'm going to get the conversation over to the next one.
I'll come to that. I'm going to smash your puerta today, man.
You're going to smash me.